celebrate our 8th annual playmaking intensive with New York City Public School students ages 10 to 16. These students and the teaching artists and leaders have been doing an incredible job this week, and I'm so excited to share their work with you. We're going to start with a little video about giving you sort of an inside scoop on some of what went on this week.
What's so amazing about this program is we build in flexibility. So if we've got a super active group of kids who are really confident and amazing, we will bring exercises that will be based around that. If we've got a group that's a little bit more shy or really need help like focusing, then each day all of the teaching artists get together and we kind of like, okay, what can we do tomorrow that's best going to work for this group?
And this is such an inclusive program, and so there is obviously the aspect of writing and acting, but there's also design and a lot of elements that students can learn, just a wholehearted look at what it takes to make theater.
We play to the strengths of our teaching artists. So we bring in professional working writers and actors and directors, designers, to come and teach workshops on the things that they do. So it's an incredible opportunity for these students. They get to be taught by people who are working in the field.
If you actually pursue theater as a profession, it gets to a point where you're like, I gotta make my living, and it becomes less playful. And so it's so good to be reminded that like there's a reason these are called plays.
No!
And I think it's awesome also taking away this idea that you have to be good. You know, so you have to be a great writer, you have to be a great actor. No, just sit there and make something.
Yeah.
You know, and build community with people who don't look like you, who aren't from the same place as you're from, who you all can learn from one another. So community is so beautiful, and I think the kids are really picking that up and really learning that to kind of deal with each other in interesting ways.
So to tell you a little bit more about the incredible work that the students have been doing, I'd like to introduce the leaders of this year's program, Anna Lloyd Bradshaw, Xandra Clark, and Kathy George, to come on up.
Thank you so much for coming out and supporting us. I'm really, really excited to share what the students have been working on. It's been a really magical week. So I'm sure you have heard about a lot of the games and exercises that we do. So we thought rather than just kind of telling you guys and talking you through it, we'd show you. So I know that everybody really loves audience participation. So can you all lift your hands up for me, students? That's you guys too. You guys know how this goes. So we are going to try. We're going to make a little bit of magic today, and we're all going to clap at the same time. So you've got to really watch my hands. And watch out for the people next to you. This is a really great way.
Yes, please. We have a whole show after that. really awesome game that we like to call Bippity Bippity.
Yeah.
All right, so, Ken, are you in there? Are we ready?
Yes.
Bippity Bippity.
Yay!
What's the sound? Don't forget sound.
Oh, yay.
Good.
Ta-da.
Scenes and monologues, basically. Sashihara. Joe's in the bathroom of the coffee house, where he and Katie Judge went to eat. Joe looks in the mirror.
Joe, look at the facts. She has a boyfriend whom she seems to like, and she's the judge on the case that you're working on. And neither of us are going to quit it. And why would she choose you over her hotshot attorney who wins all of his cases? Okay, let's just see how this lunch goes. Maybe you can do this against all odds.
Joe McJonas is on a date with Farzana. They're at a sushi place.
California roll is my favorite, but I'll also have shrimp tempura. What would you like?
I'll have whatever.
Lovely.
Joe goes to speak to the manager. He's about to propose, so the manager helps Joe.
I think I want a break from my job.
I think you deserve it, but I don't think I'll be able to come because I just don't have the job.
Well, I'll wait till you're able to come along.
Wrong timing, but I was wondering if you want ice cream or wrong.
Yes, of course.
Farzana finishes their food and the manager sets up flowers and puts on her favorite song, Perfect, by Ed Sheeran. Joe's on his knees about to propose.
I just want her to love me the way I love her. It's just not fair. The life isn't fair, you know. It doesn't go as planned. The judge is the prettiest human I've ever seen. I mean, other than myself. But she already involved and has two children. But here's the catch. He's ugly and I'm handsome. Maybe she'll leave him. After all, I was there when he wasn't, which was most of the time. I don't know what to do because I don't know if she's willing to leave him. I'm gonna feel like a complete idiot. I'll just sleep on it.
Dylan? Dang, you're really close when you're little.
Wow, well, sorry.
That's all you have to say? I cannot believe this. I wasted all of my time thinking we were going to be together. I gotta go home. Please wait. Forget it. My break is over. I gotta head back.
I'll go with you.
No, I can go alone.
Joe walks out. Amanda starts to cry and heads back to work.
What's amazing about the scenes that you just heard and are about to hear, another set of scenes, they were written one day, all right? And so they had just one session with a playwriting guest artist on two different occasions. They worked on different prompts, and this one was about conflict. And so English sentences, they're non-existent in my book, in my brain. You're about to see a bunch of short scenes with a bunch of arguments and conflicts.
I'm written by Carter Montgomery. Sorry, Johnny and Sloppy Joe go to a diner, still mad at each other from earlier. They're trying to stay calm until Johnny takes French fries from Sloppy Joe's plate.
Why are you done? I'm reading.
Can I watch your brother?
Yeah, Fatty, we need to make eating food that doesn't belong to you.
Who you calling Fat?
You and your mom, and my dad.
At least I got a mom, you're a doctor.
As long as I don't look as fat as Leon.
What?
You heard me. You look like a giant yoga ball.
I saw Leon on the way to Planet Fitness.
Jumana Abuleva. Stephanie and Jennifer are best friends that can't agree on where to eat.
We always eat at Popeyes. I want something new.
Well, Popeyes is so good. I love it.
Well, I'm tired of it. Let's eat somewhere else.
Okay, fine. We can eat wherever you want.
Next one, written by Kira Romaine Portlet. Laura runs toward Louise and elbows past her.
What's your problem?
Oh, yeah. Like you don't know.
Okay, so what I told them, you were asking for it.
What did I ever do to you?
That's what you did.
That was a joke.
Yeah, a joke that got me detention.
Yeah, did you give me detention? That's how you sound.
Next morning, Reed throws cereal at her twin.
And I have a problem.
Next up, Jesus Rivera.
I want a PS4 so I can play Fortnite.
What? You want a PS4 and you want to get my game face.
Why? Okay, next match.
Next one is written by Rabia Asin.
Hush!
Hey, anyone seen my toothbrush?
No, I didn't.
You probably took it.
Well, go buy a new one.
Why don't you? You're the one who took it.
Okay, now you're accusing me of stealing?
Well, who else would take it?
Why would I take it?
You make a point.
By Layla Lesson. T'Challa and Suri are looking at Suri's new inventions. Suri's really mad.
Suri, why are you mad?
Why am I mad? You just broke my newest invention.
What? Sorry.
Whatever. Mother needs you in the throne room.
Okay. Well, Suri, always remember, behind the bed.
I try.
What do you need, Mother? I have to go to a backup.
Why?
What do you mean, we?
Who do you think you are talking to like that? You're coming because I'm making you up.
Okay, I'll be
there. Thanks for being my Lily May. Sasha and Roy are sitting on short, stubby grass in Central Park. Sasha's mad.
What the heck, Roy?
What?
You know what you did.
What did I do?
You...
Sasha, get away from Roy, now!
Well, bye.
Bye. Wait, you jerk, come back here!
Sasha sticks up her pinky finger.
Oh, that boy's a jerk.
Mom hits Sasha. Roy smiles. Next group by Name and Web.
Mom, we have to get to the house and save the garage before Burr's next.
Calm down. I'm driving there as fast and safe as possible.
Well, we need to be there now. It takes 30 seconds for the car to move.
Would you stop screaming in my ear before you crash?
5 minutes later.
Help! Help! Somebody help me, please!
Five minutes later.
Thank you so much for saving me!
You need a boy and girl? Do you guys want to volunteer? Artists love teaching, I think, across the board, because we learn so much by doing that it's really enriching for us to get to pass that on to a younger generation. One of the first things that you kind of ask yourself about your character that you're playing is what do they want from the scene, right? And yeah. Their beliefs.
Mitchell.
For the record, this is not mine.
Okay.
Alright, I didn't write that.
We just found that on the street outside.
Yeah, I did.
Yesterday, some of them read their work out loud, and they were like, it was awful. Why was it terrible?
Because
it didn't make sense. That's how you learn in art, is by messing up, I think. As a playwright, as an actor, I think even more, mostly as a playwright, I would tell them, you know, putting pen to paper is the hardest thing because you're afraid that it's not going to be as good on the page as it was in your mind.
That's true.
Do you feel like you learned something from hearing out loud?
Yeah.
So hearing yourself out loud is really, first of all, it's always scary.
I think that first drafts are important. I think they're amazing. I think that's where you can be messy and where things cannot make sense and you can be okay with it and understand that that's not where it ends.
All the time, and I get incredibly nervous when I have to hear my stuff out loud, like shaky and like, I wanna. But the only way that you're gonna find out is if you take that leap and actually write something down.
It's true.
Do you feel like you learned something from hearing that loud?
Not like
It's really the only way that you get better as an artist is to do and then fail and then get better and then do and then fail and get better. If you keep it all in your mind the whole time, you're never going to make any improvement.
She has a boyfriend whom she seems to like, and she's the judge on the case that I'm working on, and neither of us are going to quit it. And why would she choose you over her hotshot attorney who wins all of his cases?
Ooh. Would you stop screaming at my ear before we crash?
I'm only going to hear.
Help, help, somebody help me, please.
I'm on the ladder chair, I'm coming for you.
Thank you so much for saving me.
It's my job to protect the people of New York.
I wasn't supposed to say that. It's out now.
okay? Is everything fine?
Kind of.
But not really. What do you mean?
It's going to be awkward seeing the brothers here at the dance.
I don't know, but...
What's up with John? Why is he acting crazy?
He's just being weird lately.
You should go talk to him. Maybe he's stressed out from his crazy lifestyle. But why would he decide to be part of the mom?
I don't know, but let's just try to have fun tonight, I guess.
Get the girls!
You handle Donald, get the girls. What? We need to go
for now.
No, just
breathing. Oh! Ow!
Oh, no. I'm so sorry.
Screw you and your sorry!
Leave her alone!
You killed my brother!
You don't have to do this! You could have been a better person! You killed my best friend and now you hurt my sister! Who else is next?
Now it's your turn.
Oh!
Wow, you're the stupidest person I ever met. You took a bullet from me.
I ain't done yet.
You're going to jump for a lifetime, boy. You think you know so much?
Yeah, sure.
Are you okay?
I'm an echo.
Sorry for your loss.
think I appreciate it, but you need to know the truth.
Wait, what's the truth?
Your parents' death was an accident.
What? How do you know?
I have my resources.
Well, who are your resources?
I don't kiss them tail.
Oh, shoot. Sorry, Brian. Look at the time. I have to go pick up my little sister from school.
Time this week because I couldn't be here for a couple days. Stephanie Osio also worked with them. But this play came from this really simple improv exercise where one person just came up with a name and then the other two actor or three actor artists just asked them questions. And they came up with this whole scenario in life of all these people very quickly and they ran with it and that's what their play is. They just, their first impulse, which is amazing, it is called The Gymnast in Court. Written and starring Lucas Mann, Amia McDonald, Tony Roller, Rabia Asif, Rabia Asif, Natalia, Natalia Gammon, and with a special guest appearance by Lily Mann, the Gymnast in Court.
5, 6, 7, and.
Sigo el ritmo, baby, yo siento el tambor. Hemos
contest for gymnastics. Amanda, how does it feel to become the bronze?
I'm probably proud of myself, but I feel like I could have done better.
Who is your main inspiration for this contest?
My cousin Dominique. She's been there for me for a while.
Ooh, she's kind of cute. I wish I could get a chance to work with her.
Patrick? Huh? That's my cousin. Ew.
Oh, you know I didn't mean it like that.
Ooh, sure you did.
Go back to the max. You need a working assignment.
Is your cousin single? Why?
Because I have a nephew, and I think those two kids might hit it off. You know?
So what's his name?
Francisco, yes.
I never knew you had a cousin, I mean a nephew.
Yeah, there's a lot of things you don't know about me. Keep talking.
With almond milk and chai right away.
Thank you.
writer, Francisco Hughes.
Rise, all rise.
Francisco Hughes, you have been accused of false advertisement and sexual harassment. How do you feel about these charges? Well, with all the mountain of evidence that has been presented, I find you guilty as charged. Dismissed.
I knew it all along. I gotta go to the bathroom.
Okay, we'll be done then.
This is all your fault. You caused this. You should have never brought this creep here. Not only could you have ruined your career, but you also put our star client in danger.
It's not my fault. He emailed me first.
You
I
need help.
At
a,
I
everyone.
I looked at his resume. It looked good.
You can't trust everybody.
Amanda! No!
Drive there.
Then drive faster. This Julian won't sell itself.
Where were you? I've been waiting for 30 minutes!
I'm so sorry that I was traffic.
I want to hear your excuses. They're nothing but rubbish. If it happens again, I won't hesitate to fire you.
Mr. Ski? Okay, Annie, deep breath. I know how terrible Scummy Ski is, but just remember, it's all for Mila. She worked so hard to get into Yale, and I don't need to stress about not being able to proceed. I just want to say how sorry I am, and it won't happen again.
And decided I would come see you at work.
How are you?
I'm good. I really like Yale, but I have a huge load of laundry that needs to be done.
Okay, I just have to wrap up.
Mila, hello. Just dropped your mom. Where are you doing?
Hi. It's nice to see you too, Mr. Ski.
Oh, lucky.
I'm just finishing up.
Why do you put up with that horrid man? I know that you can't stand him.
Don't speak so loudly. It's really okay. You might sometimes. Once you wish him happy birthday.
Was it your birthday?
Let's just go home. I can teach you how to do your own laundry.
Seriously, Mom. Why do you let him push you around like that? You should quit or at least stand up for yourself. I'm positive that you could find another job.
Well, finding jobs is time.
Time that you have.
All right, Mila, that's enough. I only have a little bit of time with you, and I don't want to spend it fighting.
Mom, I don't understand.
No, you don't.
It's not worth it. Nothing's that important.
Well, some things are that important.
Like what?
Never mind. Forget I said anything.
No, Mom, tell me.
Fine. If you really want to know, I have to pay for half your tuition.
I don't understand. I got a scholarship.
You only got half a scholarship, but it's okay. Working for Mrs. P.
I'm so sorry, Mom. We can stop talking about it. She works so hard, and for such a noble cause, and you give her so much crap, and all she's trying to do is put me through school.
I thought you had a full scholarship.
Well, I don't.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Well, now you do.
Thank you. and that, you know, that something could be in play. So, you know, it was a little bit of an adult theme, but I hope everybody feels comfortable and, you know, obviously talk to the younger kids about what we saw. I do want to just also introduce everybody to, invite everybody to Colt Coeur's upcoming world premiere, which is called Zurich. So today the students got to see one of the scenes from the play that is featuring a 12-year-old who's a New York City public school student and a 16-year-old, and they did a scene for the students, and the students got to do a talk back with the actor and the playwright and myself. I'm the director of the play. And we would love to invite you all to come see the play. We have a dress rehearsal next Friday night, and we also will send you information about how to come see the play other ways. Before we do our final game, I also just wanted to say, we'll be putting the plays together into a booklet like this. So if you fill out this yellow card and put your address on it, we'll send it to you. We also have a video of the show tonight that we can email you. So fill this out. If you, you know, can support the work that we do, that'd be amazing. You can drop something in here, or you can write your credit card, or drop a check in here. Amy, right here, will be sort of out with the drinks and snacks, and you can give her this. Also, we have these tote bags, which are $10. If you want to have one, you can get one for $10. Thank you so much, and this is our final game. Woo-hoo. Yeah.
All right, we're going to do a little bonus game. We have everyone up on the stage.
Yeah.
Call me maybe.
What's your number?